Chinook Winds in concert. Tonight, we take you back in time to a more simple, more carefree time. So please sit back and enjoy the Chinook Winds in My Funny Valentine. The date is February 14, 1941. The place is New Orleans, and love is in the air. Happy dance club. Dancers spin around the floor to sultry tangos and whirling waltzes. Men hunts walk in the air, and as smoke from Cuban cigars curl around the faces. The girls smile down at the soles of their head caps, as if challenging the men to ask them to dance. The war is fully underway in Europe, but in here, thoughts are only in ordering another drink and asking the prettiest gal in the club to dance.
Completely transfixed.
Miss Oboe takes a seat at the bar, right next to him. She sizes him up and says to Mr. Horn,
"You alone on Valentine's Day, too? What a joke of a holiday. I'll have the usual."
"Yes, Mom."
"Are you new in town? I ain't never seen you around these parts before. I know most of these men in the club. They're always trying to pick me up, take me out, buy me things, show me out to their friends, but I'm sick of it. I'm just looking for someone to love, you know what I'm saying?" "But you, there's something different about you, something that I like. Want to dance?"
Dumbfounded that woman.
Thank you.
years.
Oh my, look at the time. I must get going.
But wait, where can I find you? Can I send you a telegram?
I don't know. I just know that I have to go. We'll see each other around, I'm sure of it.
I'll see you later, my funny Valentine.
Thank you.
following the attack on Pearl Harbor, Mr. Horn included. And many of the young women are now working in factories or volunteering as nurses. This year, at the Latin Dance Club, only a few couples fill about.
Thank you.
The doctor informs Mr. Warren.
The usual nurse went back to Butte, Montana to her family. You have a new nurse this afternoon, okay?
Although he got along well with the previous nurse, Mr. Warren is looking forward to a new face in the ward. And after the doctor leaves to continue on his rounds, Mr. Warren falls asleep and dreams of Miss Oboe watching him.
Bye.
uniform, holding his medication in hand, is Miss Oboe.
It's coming!
It's you!
It's you!
Oh, my dear Mr. Horn, I'm so sorry I left you a year ago. I haven't been able to stop thinking of you, and I'm just so sorry that I'm...
My dear Miss Oboe, no explanations are needed. All that matters is that you're here, and I'm here. And I love you.
I love you too.
Your words have magically cured me. Oh, I can't bear to be without you for any longer. Will you marry me?
And so, after some hasty preparations.
Our lives together will really be the start of something.